I'm just going to sum up a little, having listened to this. And I'm starting where we were. Look at this graph. These are all the countries. I have money down here, $400, $4,000, $40,000. Remember, two zeros difference in income across the countries of the world. Zeros in the end is the most important number on the paycheck. Everyone agrees on that. The number, which number it's in the beginning is not so important. It's the number of zeros you have, which is important. Here I had the proportion of young people, and we heard that the Arab world, North Africa, had that amazing higher proportion. But what I want to compare is three countries here, Denmark, Malaysia, South Africa, and Uganda. And when you look at it today, it seems like South Africa, Malaysia, and Denmark are much more similar because they have almost the same number of zeros on the paycheck, on the average paycheck. But there are different types of paychecks in South Africa, we heard. Whereas Uganda is quite low down here, and yet we heard that the middle-income people start to grow very fast in Uganda. This is one more of these things. You get the aggregate statistic, you have to drill down. We have to, even now, from having just numbers available, they must be available in a way we can understand it. The first thing I do here is going to my favorite, number of children per woman. So I color by one number of children per woman. And look here, where it's blue, it's where they are 2.5, South Africa, 2.5. South Africa is a world average. If someone comes from outer space and want to see how are you living in the world, I just have half a day to visit, I'll send them down to South Africa because you have the whole stuff. It's a representative sample down there, you know. Whereas here in Uganda, it's 5 to 6 children per woman. Can you see that this group of countries, about 16% of world population, still have that big number of children? And why children are not growing is because this group is compensated by so many countries here that have less than 2 children per woman. Lowest of all, Hong Kong, 1 child per woman. The only part of China where Mao Zedong never had a 1 child policy. So there's something special with that. The emerging markets get few children and really invest in them. Here it's another situation. Yet you are right that the middle class is growing very fast in Uganda. So I have to drill down and I have to get this into income distributions. Let me go over to look at this. This is yet another of these prototypes which Daniel and Gapminder is working on to go one step further from information in graphic to understanding. Here's once more the income, $100, $1,000, $10,000, $100,000. You see, when we have the income distribution in people, we need 4 zeros to show the world. Because there are some Donald Trumps over there, you know, which have quite a high income. And they are in parts of East Nile in northern Uganda, war-torn, very poor. You have people all the way down there. So how can we make this world distribution comprehensive? This is South Africa, the orange. You can see South Africa in 1970. This is during apartheid. They covered the whole distance. Amazingly, the country. This was Uganda. They were on the poorer side. Malaysia was a little better here, but also a developing country. And Denmark, I picked Denmark because it had a suitable size here, but it's just representative of West Europe, and it's over here. So we said this was the Western world, and this was the developing world. But look what has happened. I'm going to gradually change the income distribution of the world, and this is how it happens, and how countries move. And you see average move in some countries, distribution move in others, and then we end up here. And suddenly, Malaysia moved over from this end to that end. That very successful Muslim tropical country had moved over here. And Denmark is here. And within the distribution of South Africa, you have one Denmark, you have one Malaysia. It's inside South Africa. Whereas Uganda goes largely outside, yet you have the growing middle class here. Indeed, you have it. And it's growing fast because it comes from almost zero. It comes from almost zero. And they are really entrepreneurial. But in East Nile, up to what now will be southern Sudan, you know, you have dreadful poverty. Take this segmentation into consideration when you draw conclusions. Here, even people may not afford those cheap bed nets. You have to give them for free. You have to give them for free. Here, you can start subsidizing them. Here, people can pay for them entirely themselves. You have to think in segments. And we still need aid, and we need donations for free things over in this end. Here people can run their own business. And both this is within Uganda. We have so interesting. We have these software programs for the cell phone to collect survey data. And one of my PhD students became professor in Norway. He applied to the Norwegian Research Council of money to develop this. Not aid money, just pure research money. And he outsourced it, and his colleague, professor on computer science in Kampala, is developing with a fantastic group of software developers in Uganda. And they're not planning on how they would put it. This, you can have so much in Uganda, but see how very few Ugandans. There's no Donald Trump in Uganda yet. There's no one who has made it all the way there. But in South Africa, there are people who have made it sort of all the way. This is what I would like to leave you with. This enormous distribution in the world. And don't think Western world, developing world. Don't think the world and sub-Saharan Africa. Don't think Uganda. See all the different opportunities in the same time, free bed nets, subsidized bed nets, people can pay for their own bed nets within the same country. And that means that we have to break down the data to make sense of it. Thank you very much.